This technique can create any kind of rain effect, from a drizzle to downpour, and is incredibly versatile. I will use it to add drama to this neon-lit portrait. But first, I have a long-awaited announcement. There were some delays, I'm sorry. But the winners of our bi-monthly contest are here. I put them up on screen. I just want to give a big congratulations to both winners. This piece in particular kept popping up in my favorites when I looked through all of the entries, despite being nothing but gray tones, which I love, by the way. It still just stood out so much. I love the PM rune assets in the back, and my eye is drawn directly to the subject each and every time. This screams sexy gothic vampire novella. Wonderful job. And our second winner. I hoped people would really lean into the gothic architecture and building side of things, and this delivered that. Exactly. It gives me crazy dinner room vibes from Bloodborne, which is always a good thing in my book. Wonderful work. A great job to both winners. You both win a $150 gift card for photomanipulation.com, which you have both received. And shout out to these runner-ups. You all did a fabulous job. The links to both the winners and all the runner-ups' social medias are going to be down in the description. Please give them a follow, they deserve it. And to everyone else who entered, thank you. I actually have a 40% off coupon for you, or not just for you guys, everyone. Use code LOVE40 to get 40% off your purchase starting today, the 15th, until next Thursday. Photos, 3D assets, Photoshop courses, and more. If you're a genre artist, we're gonna have what you need. Thank you so much again to everyone who entered. Don't feel down if you didn't win. I'll be announcing the next contest very soon. In fact, stay tuned till the end of this video to find out just how soon. But we gotta get into this rain effect. I'm breaking this down into two sections. I'm making the rain texture and then the several ways you can edit and apply that rain texture. First, let's create a layer and fill it with a solid black color. And then go to Filter, Pixelate, Mezzotint, setting the type to coarse dots. Name this layer Dots. Now we're going to zoom in nice and close to the white dots and go to Select, Color Range. Here we're going to click on a dot and adjust the fuzziness to 200, press OK. And all that does is select those white dots so we can then add a layer mask to mask them. Then hop right into Select a Mask, found in the Properties panel. And so in Global Refinements, set the feather to 2 pixels and contrast to 50%. And this is going to thin out the dots. The more dots, the heavier the rain is going to appear, so feel free to play with these settings. We don't want too many dots in this case. Now we're going to duplicate the dots layer twice using Control/Command-J for a total of 3 dot layers. And then select all those dot layers and right-click Merge Layers. And this will make the dots appear brighter or more solid. Give them a bit more oomph. And because we're working with a portrait, I'm going to increase the size of the dots now as opposed to later. It doesn't really matter, but I know I want them nice and big. So how are we going to make these dots look like rain? With a blur filter, of course, but not the one you might think. We're going to go to Filter, Blur Gallery, Path Blur, Instant Motion Blur. But why use Path Blur and not Motion Blur? Because here we can actually create movement in the rain by placing points on the path and pulling. You always want your rain to be going in more than one direction, even if it's very subtle. Ultimately, I want the rain to be vertical, but adding a slight wave will give me a more organic effect. Bringing us to a movement speed. If we want full-blown downpour rain, 50 to 75% works great. However, I want more photographic style rain, so let's bring this down from 20 to 25%. We can always add more movement later if we need to, go lower as opposed to higher. Let's duplicate this a couple more times and merge them again. And then 2 more times after that, only we won't merge them. Instead, we're going to increase each layer by 50 to 200%. Ideally, you want 3 sizes of rain texture. A small, a medium, and a large. These are going to be your base rain textures. How you edit these textures will 100% depend on the effect you want and the actual image you're applying it to. One of the reasons I chose this image is because I can throw out a ton of potential options like adjusting color, thickness, brightness, and size. So let's start with the most important, in my opinion, color, because your rain should almost never be white unless it's a black and white photo. Now you could go to hue/saturation and add a tint of color there, however this image's lighting is just more complex than that. She's bathed in a blue light from the front and has this strong red backlight. Water is clear, so it's going to reflect and catch the lights and colors that it's surrounded by. Let's save copies of our rain texture, just in case. Next, create a duplicate of our subject and go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. We want to add about 30 pixels of blur. Doesn't really matter. Now we are going to clip the blur layer into each and every rain texture, and this will make the rain temporarily become invisible. Now, actually, if we wanted a really subtle rain effect, we could just resize and move around these blur layers. And this could end up being a really great finish effect on a darker photo or composite like this. It won't really work that well with brightly lit stuff, just darker stuff. But we don't want subtle in this case. Let's undo all of that. Instead, we're going to merge the rain texture and the clipped blur layers together, keeping each individual, just merge all three. One by one. Set all three layers to screen, then increase each rain texture by 10 to 20% to add an offset kind of effect. That's how you can add multiple colors in your rain super quick that match its environment. Sometimes flat colors will work just fine, but I prefer the blur method in dramatic lighting situations like this, where there is a specific light source and we want to really hit that light source. But now let's talk about controlling the rain. Right now it's still very static and flat, and that's just because we haven't added any perspective to the rain. It's all just flat. All the rain is in front of her and she's behind all of the rain. And this just comes down to duplicating our subject, selecting them, masking them, and then bringing the smallest rain texture right below them. This rain is furthest from the camera, that small rain, so it needs to be behind our subject. But now we're going to start building up the brightness in the rain and kind of the sparkly bits. Just like before, we can start by duplicating our rain layers and setting those duplicates to color dodge. However, do not be afraid to experiment with different layer modes. Everything from now on is based on just getting the vibe we want. There is no set formula. It's really just about playing around. Let's put those duplicates into a masked group. We're going to invert that group's mask using Control/Command-I, turning it black. And now we can use a soft white brush to mask the areas we want to be nice and bright, or at least brighter. You can always duplicate and adjust the layers inside of this group to be as bright as you need. Like I said, from now on, we're really just layering and combining our existing rain textures. We're just building up the rain. For example, we can duplicate the large rain texture and increase it to give even more of foreground rain. We can then duplicate that rain texture to make it nice and bright. Let's set it to overlay. We can also edit the brightness of the rain textures themselves because they do have colors on them. I'm going to increase the brightness of this overlay layer by a lot. Also, don't be shy about playing with layers set to normal. I want to add some very bright raindrops for even more detail. So I'm going to grab a copy of the original medium rain texture and tint it to a red hue using hue saturation, making sure colorize is checked. And this is the quickest way to do this. And next, I'm going to hold down Control/Command and click that medium rain texture, giving us a selection. And then in our handy dandy context bar, let's contract by 2 pixels, that selection here, and then to add a layer mask. And this is a great way to thin out your rain without making a new texture. Apply the layer mask and duplicate the layer a few times. And I'm actually going to repeat that until I get the effect I want. And actually, that's kind of the case in general. Keep duplicating, masking, and expanding with these different layer modes until you have the rain effect you want. And finally, we want to mask away the rain areas or any pesky raindrops that are just too distracting. And while you can do that while you go, I like to save it for the end. I also just realized that this rain effect would have been handy during the Gothic contest. Congratulations to the winners one last time. Please check out their links down in the description. They all deserve a follow, as well as that 40% off coupon for photomanipulation.com, which you all deserve, running from today till Thursday. Why Thursday? That's when a new contest will be announced. I'm working on getting a very special prize for it, but no promises and no spoilers yet. You can keep up to date with me and all of my personal projects by following me on Twitter, Yes, I'm on Twitter now. I don't particularly love it, but also Instagram, as always. And I'll see you guys very soon.